It's a road we love and hate in almost equal measure. It's 127 miles long and has 62 junctions. For those of us who live in Felixstowe, it's an essential because it's the way by which we get by road to the rest of Britain, whether that be London, the Midlands or wherever. So in the next few videos, I'm going to be exploring the A14, some of the places on it and some of the places nearby, and see what we can learn from those places. The A14 has been vital in the development of the port of Felixstowe, and it's also been significant in the economic development of towns along its route, like Ipswich, Cambridge and Kettering. It's also brought a whole new series of names into our collective psyche: Brampton Hut, Spittles, Girton, Copdock, Seven Hills, all places where people get stuck in traffic jams. And talking of jams, do you remember the Hawley Bends? They're gladly no longer with us. And then, of course, there's significant structures on the road, like the Orwell Bridge. The A14 typifies the way we often do things in Britain. What we needed was a brand new highway linking Felixstowe with the Midlands industrial towns. What we actually got was a decision to improve the existing A45 and other roads instead. This was a cheaper solution than constructing a completely new road, but with the wisdom of hindsight, it left us with congestion points, like the whole section between Huntingdon and Cambridge, and very dangerous sections like the Hawley Bends. Hawley's now been sorted out, but the problem of the section between Huntingdon and Cambridge still needs serious addressing. But as the improvements were being planned, it was also realised that with the growth of Cambridge and the development of Felixstowe, a completely different alignment was needed to the west of Cambridge, and it was decided to improve the existing A604 between Cambridge and Kettering and build a completely new road between Kettering and the M1-M6 junction at Catthorpe, right in the heart of the Midlands motorway hub. This became known as the A1-M1 link, and when it was first proposed in 1974, it suffered severe opposition. It then went through a torturous process of public inquiries and legal challenges, and eventually opened in 1994, completing the 127-mile route. In fact, calling the road the A14 was quite a late invention. The original A14 was a short road between Royston and Huntingdon. As the route of the new road was so far off the route of the original A45 west of Cambridge, early sections were designated the A604, but the Department of Transport wanted a single designation right through. So in 1994, they redesignated the old A14 to a new number and called the new road from Catthorpe to Felixstowe the new A14. The whole route may not have fully opened until 1994, but the A14 quickly became a very busy artery into East Anglia. And as much as we may complain about the congestion, even locally here in Suffolk, we need to be reminded that before the coming of the Orwell Bridge, to go to London or the Midlands involved going through Ipswich. The A14, when completed, cut significant time off the journey from the Midlands to Felixstowe. I've said much about journeys in a few of my recent videos, but however good or bad our journey of life may be, the destination for everyone is the same. We can think much of the journey and prepare ourselves as much as possible for it. What about preparing for the end? When are we planning to think about that? When we're on a journey, such as along the A14, we know where the end is. It's predictable. It's expected. But life? That's different. The end can be very unexpected, and God doesn't want us to be caught off guard. For two reasons. First of all, God has already provided a way by which we can know Him and be assured of our eternal future, and that's through trusting Jesus Christ. But secondly, God would like to take that journey of life with us. But whether we take Him on board or not is down to us. Well, thanks for listening, and God bless you.